All right, guys, as you guys are aware, we did the first car metal, the total artificial heart here in Kentucky in a lady. You know, it's a major step towards, like, you know, using technology in medicine and, you know, how we've come a long way. Like, you know, just like 50 years ago, we didn't have even treatment for, severe three-vessel disease. Like, you know, we didn't have open bypasses and those kind of things, but we've come a long way from open bypasses to stenting to, like, drug-eluting stents and, you know, all the good stuff now to, like, total artificial hearts. We've come a long way. So yeah, let's check out the functionality. Of course, I cannot show you guys the patient. I can always go over the machine that's been implanted in her, and we'll try to have a better understanding of you know, how these things are working. So let's see.
All right, guys, so before we go over the real machine, let's go over a few basic things. So blood, all the deoxygenated blood is coming to the right side of the heart. This is the right side of the heart. This is the left side of the heart. So all the deoxygenated blood is coming to the right side of the heart, where the right ventricle is squeezing all that blue blood, if you see the deoxygenated blood, to the lungs to get oxygenated. And the oxygenated blood is coming through from the left atrium to the left ventricle. And where the left ventricle is squeezing all the blood out through the aorta. So if you see the red part is the oxygenated blood, and of course the blue part is the deoxygenated blood. So you see, when in diastole, the ventricle is kind of relaxing, so the blood kind of pulls up in the right ventricle and the left ventricle. And when both of them squeeze together at the same time, one is throwing blood in the lungs and the other one is throwing blood into the aorta, so that, you know, they wait for the next cycle to happen. So this is how the cycle of the heart is working every time. And this is actually what the total artificial heart is doing, the function of the right ventricle and the left ventricle. So it's kind of relaxing. So at the same time, so you're pulling up blood and then contracting, so that, you know, all that blood is going through in the right chambers. So truly amazing concept. Let's take a look at the real one now.
All right, guys, this is the total artificial heart. So you see LV flow and the RV flow. This is going through the left ventricle. This is going through the right ventricle. See, the purple lines are the left ventricle flow, the blue lines are the RV flow, and the heart rate is being decided based on the outflow, those pumps. Now if you see, the diastolic pressures are negative, so you want the diastolic pressures to be negative for the heart to, like, really suck in, and then the systolic pressure on the left side, the LV, right side RV. So you want diastolic pressures to be lower, close to zero, so it really sucks in, and then the systolic pressure to be high, so it gives a good output. So diastolic pressures are good, so it's sucking in good, and then systolic pressures are good, so it's pumping blood out really nice. Fancy device.
As I said, this is a very fancy device. So what it does is, like, it relaxes, and that's when the heart actually gains all the blood, and when it squeezes, it's pushing all the blood forward to all parts of the body. So, very fancy device. Step again towards a better progression of life. And let's see how things go from here. Thank you.